Let's Play Series 4, Fallout 4. And today we're going to be doing two relatively short explorations. First, we're going to go and explore a pit hole. And this is a literal pit hole, where it looks like the last 200 years have led to a whole lot of erosion. Or sinkhole, and so we're going to go and see what we can see there. Now, there is a little bit of complication here in that this is not exactly the safest place to be. And I think we'll see why in a sec. I might be hearing why just now. In case you didn't hear that, there's a weird grumbly animal sound. Nearby. Quite sure where it is. Just heard it again. But we're not sure where it came from. So we will walk around a little bit. Is, but we probably take care of that. Sure would be nice though to figure out where that noise was coming from. Let's move over here. This looks like if this were Skyrim, some of this rock looks like it would be mineable. Of course it's not. There is that stingling again. Hey, Hancock.
Hmm?
Grab that.
Bingo.
So maybe Hancock is gonna go and do that, or maybe it's not. We're gonna see. Oh, apparently this winds up. It winds considerably upwards, and there's some stuff. Not a lot. Stingwings. Apparently I have fairly shitty aim. There is Hancock. He's moving his way along. So we asked him to go and grab an antifreeze bottle for us. The Stingwings are actually trying to figure out where they can where we are. Let's see if we can take them out. Maybe not that one. Something nice. One stingwing down. So we've kind of tipped our hand. Not quite sure how to do it.
Leave alone.
The origin of that monstery noise. Oh well, let's just keep on going.
You better.
Looks like there's another stingwing up there somewhere. Steamer trunks. But we're not interested in just getting near the we're gonna go down into it. In reality, this would probably be a pretty steep event because you would have no idea how deep it is. And you would also have to guarantee that if it's not going to land you parked up against some sharp rocks, or even if there's any escape route.
That would be great damage, guys.
There is a way forward. I'm guessing what all this means is that presumably some people came down here in the past and they got stuck somehow. Maybe the earth. Come back to the house, but maybe it wasn't always that wasn't always the case. Just speculation. Stuff, lots of stuff. Yeah, get lots of good loot. Yep. Probably a lot of loot that I don't need, but we're so near our settlements that we can pretty much just grab anything. We don't have to be picky.
Tell me that smell's not you, because otherwise, you need to see a doctor.
That is. There's the other possibility that the people fell into the sinkhole, had happy long lives, and then after dying they turned into ghouls.
Must have been one hell of an exodus out of this place.
A lot of stuff in here. If you were to come to the outside of this house and try and make your way in, you would find that it's sealed. Now, not very well sealed.
This neighborhood sure got vacated recently.
And that kind of chain there, it's not going to be particularly effective.
Nice.
On the other hand, anybody trying to bust in would probably make a good amount of noise, so if you had to secure yourself, that would certainly be better than nothing. Although I suspect if you were worried about invasion, probably your best tack is to make it so that people don't even know that there's somebody in an area, rather than just make it hard to enter that area. Rather than making it just hard to enter that area. But, oh well. Oh, hello.
What was that?
People I like.
Show us what you got!
Funny.
Stuff. There we go. Cool. So, lots of stuff that we can get for our little settlers. Let's see. Is there anything that we want? I think that we were building up our strength to start taking levels in Strong Back. Okay, so now we're eligible to take the perk. And so the next time we do it, we can take the perk. And I think we're facing in the right direction, so if we just head straight ahead.
Hey,
I take...
Oh, I have so much
requests.
Weight. That's unfortunate. Yeah, so this is kind of an interesting area. You can see that there's a medical center in the background. You can see that... Yeah, this was probably a pretty decent place to live right before the war, although the houses were a little bit excessively boring. But I think that's generally true of most video games, in that you're not going to see a lot of attention paid to making houses unique or anything like that. You're going to find, just because if you're doing open world, then you typically, you only have so many people to work from. In terms of who's going to make your content, that's kind of interesting, floating rocks. And so you're going to probably try to, I thought there was a button to throw stuff. Yeah, so you're going to try to economize. You're going to want to make one kind of house a lot, which is what you see in this world. There's really one house, but it gets replicated with slight variants all over the place. Just because that's the economic way to produce content. Interesting. It would be a neat house up on the hill. Unfortunately, a lot of the more interesting houses in Fallout are sealed off. So, that house looks like it might not fit the typical building standard, but unfortunately, somebody sealed it up with wood blocks so that nobody can enter. Now, I'm not sure if that kind of ceiling was meant to have happened after the war, or maybe before the war, or just as the war was starting. It's kind of possible that it happened while the war was starting, because people were hoping to protect themselves against nasty radiation storms. That feels pretty plausible. But it's also not impossible that it was done long after the war. Like, people might have had one way to get in, so they sealed off all the rest to kind of cement their claim to an area. Or it could have been, well, I mean, I guess maybe if there were a whole lot of condemnation happening before the war. This is where we're going to be. So that's a house. These are the regular houses. And, I don't think I've changed this very much since you last might have seen it.
Got a dangerous look about you. Hope you ain't here for me.
And let's see. So that takes us down a bit. But it would be pretty nice to have a shot to film with this fun. All this stuff in it. So let's do that. We're gonna make an armor shop. I guess the other nice thing about this is it kind of seals off. You can be. Let's start
with okay. That.
Yeah, but it kind of blocks off the entry into that little sleeping area there. Which is probably a pretty welcome thing. Because otherwise, I don't know, just if you're sleeping somewhere, even if it's not a particularly nice place, having it have a certain sense of home is probably
gonna
be useful.
Armor?
Sure. Let's take a look.
Let me know what you'd like.
Okay. So, need this. Or this, or this. And the prices are actually working out pretty well here. So, we picked up a whole lot of disciples gear. But let's see if we would kind of like to have... Oh wait, wraparound goggles, really? no, that's not what we want. Okay, there are some goggles that we would really like to have that increase intelligence, but I thought it was wrapped around. Apparently I was wrong. We may have not chosen very well because we can't really buy much from him to make up for. Okay, so we'll have to reduce our sales. Maybe. Well, we certainly don't need so many of those. Okay, so we really didn't like our load that much. But
if you're looking for armor, I may have something you can use.
I'd like to trade some items.
Sure.
But we can give him some better armor for him to wear, which should lighten our load nicely. So a torn shirt and ragged jeans. Okay. Then disciples. Chest piece. Left leg, right arm. Well, so we can't give him a full assortment. Oh wait, left arm. Yeah, he doesn't have one of those yet. And right leg. Yeah, cool. Okay, so
another day of hard work. Never changes.
Okay, so the next place that we were gonna go to is the Breakheart Banks up there. But first we're gonna swing back by Bunker Hill to sell the rest of our stuff, because I didn't realize that I was unlikely to buy armor. If I had chosen a weapon vendor, then I could have bought ammo. Because there's almost no end to how much ammo you're gonna wanna have for the guns that you use. But just once you go over their cap limit,
looks like they don't get deep
all this
here.
Stuff more strongly resembles trading than,
I fixed up most of what's here myself, so it's all guaranteed.
Uh-huh. Let's see what you got.
See something you like.
Okay, so we can get rid of the bayoneted pistols and that combat rifle. Disciple stuff, which is super heavy. Oh, yeah, she just has enough cash to handle all the stuff that we were able to toss at her. Okay, that works. Okay, so to Breakheart Banks. But we're going to run there from Greentop Nursery, because if I remember right, fast traveling to that location is not at all safe.
You know what I call a good day? One that ends without an empty stomach.
Okay, so, Breakheart Banks. This is a... if I remember right where this is... no. Okay. I'm misremembering. There was a different settlement somewhere around here, but not Breakheart Banks. That is a super mutant dwelling. And I wanted to clear that. Breakheart Banks is a place that we've already been to and cleared. But that was just as part of a quest. So... we haven't ventured much in this direction. Oh, wait, actually, no, I think what we're going to do, set up to Mercer Safe House, and there's a factory that would be interesting to pay a visit to. Yes, I think you've probably seen that. But over here is a pretty interesting place. And I'm trying to remember if there was something interesting down here or not. Oh, there is. There's a hideout. Well, I don't remember what's hiding out in here. Always good to be ready for whatever life tosses at you. Okay, bunch of barrels. The air is flammable and looks like there's a whole bunch of ghouls. Ooh, oh my goodness, that is not good. A legendary putrid glowing one. Well, maybe we can... Let's try this thing. I don't remember quite what it is, but it hopefully will create some fun. Well, that was a little bit less exciting than I had hoped. But maybe... Looks like we're going to be facing some rads. Well, let's use some radix then. The silver fork. Yeah, it looks like we really did clear out this area quite nicely. But this was somebody's hideout, despite being this irradiated. Well, I guess that explains the ghouls. Some people somehow didn't realize how irradiated this place is. And they get out here. It's 10 rads even with the radaway. How is it disirradiated? Oh, that's why. Okay, all these giant barrels of radiation, or of radioactive waste. Wonderful. And we were just wandering around in it. Oh, let's head out. Okay, so that was obviously not a great place to hide out. It does have the advantage of being a place that nobody would really think to look in. But that's just completely outweighed by the concern that if you live there, you're going to be irradiated as hell. And that is not something that people should live with. Good basic idea, though, just poorly applied. Okay, as we move forward, we see some signs. I think that's probably a sign of raiders. But we're not seeing any raiders. In fact, the place seems pretty quiet. And then we find... Looks like the raiders were here, but now they're dead. Now, I will forgive... Oh, floating rocks. Interesting. The raiders for not necessarily having set this place up particularly well, because they're on the edge of the Commonwealth. Very few people would ever be out here. And so the rules that you would want to follow in doing a settlement probably differ a lot based on how populated the area is. So if you're out in the middle of nowhere, and there's probably big parts of the post-radiation United States, probably where the raiders slept, then the idea of just not hiding probably makes sense. Door here. Let's see what's down in here. Okay. No, it is to the left of center. There we go.
Sweet.
One thing I find cute in the game that you can find toy parts, and whenever you activate them, you build the toy. Anything you want in here? No. Okay. Not the most useful of areas, but let's press ahead. Just gonna make our rounds of the place before we go inside. Oh, there's a ghoul out there. Stuck on an island. Now the game doesn't really explore very well how ghouls get the energy they need to stay alive. Still making their rounds and in places. Something must have done a large coordinated attack and killed all of them. And here we are on top of the building. And here is an entrance. And let's see what we can see. Okay, more dead raiders. Makes you wonder what it was that killed this many people quickly enough that they wouldn't be centralized at all. Because if you didn't kill them, then the rest of them would move the bodies. And not be so blasé about the area. More raiders. Wonderful. Still no sign of any foes. I guess you could imagine that. Some kind of a wave of radiation, or even maybe a large flame sucking all the atmosphere out of the air. That's something that would potentially kill people without giving them a whole lot of time to think about it, and it could very quickly move throughout the area and just take care of everybody real quick.
Got it.
Guys have also been killed without really much moving around. Well, I will make good use of my long fall boots. And looks like that guy was killed in a really brutal way. So either it was intentional or it was accidental that it was that brutal.
Can't open it from this end.
Chains door. So the mystery deepens, and there's dead fish on the conveyor belt. Well, it's nice to continue to have access to,
Got it.
First aid dispensers. Oh, and there is our answer. Well, it looks like there are synths here. There are a number of them, too. Well, they haven't seen us yet, so we're going to give them a gift.
Maybe utilizing stealth. How interesting.
So it immediately ran to where we threw the grenade.
Please come out. Systems offline.
But it's not terribly bright.
Gone. Destruction is inevitable. Stealth capability.
They're just no match for our weapons. And generally this is true of the Institute. Their weapons are not good. They have the advantage of numbers, but they every individual synth is quite weak.
Disappeared. Hello. Goodbye.
Suspect, you must die.
Here you can see some more of the raiders. Presumably because these are synths they've been fighting, just got shot to bits.
Hello.
And if you find yourself...
I'd do the same if I was in as much trouble as you.
And this is a great time to stock up. But you do have to be careful not to completely have to wait a moment, but...
Now.
Cannot escape detection. The sensitivity of my sensors clearly needs adjustment. I know you are still there.
So many trays. I'm up to 218 weight now.
I am equipped.
How are we doing? 232?
The most advanced Institute sensors available. I will find you.
243.
Now I understand. You are hiding because you fear death.
That is a weird thing for synth to say. Apparently, even the Gen 2 synths are aware enough to at least attempt to understand human emotions. And they have a background on how humans would see the world, but they don't have a particularly intuitive understanding of any of this stuff. So until just then.
I must end your existence.
Okay, so we're going to take the elevator up now. We can kind of see that maybe the synths might be up there waiting for us. It. So this was a raider base, and for some reason the synths ended up seeing a use in taking it, and so they did. And apparently they were bothered that I was poking around down there, because they sent some synths upstairs and they sent some synths outside. Why was I taking so much radiation damage? So there was a radium rifle that they were firing at me.
Just say the word.
Anyhow, so what is it, the fish packing plant? Makra fish packing and the sinkhole. Two interesting places that kind of fun to visit. Didn't quite go where I thought I was going to go, but I did have a good time. Maybe now I'll just swing back by Red Rocket to end the video. So I'm trying to delay starting the main quest line until I can get Nick Valentine with me. But I would like to wrap things up with don't need that many frag grenades. It's not useful. Yep, so that's all for this video.
Intruder, identify yourself.
Not what they wanted. negative thing. Anyhow, yeah, I will see you in the next video, where I will figure out something else to do with Hancock to hopefully get us approval on a level where we can swap. Where we can swap to a different container, probably Nick Valentine. Well, I will see you in the next video, hopefully. Bye-bye.